Hello and welcome to azurewala YouTube channel. We are in part 125 of Microsoft certified associate series. So far we have completed 200 questions and 3 case studies in previous videos. Today we are going to look into question number 201. Before we proceed with today's topic, I would like to inform you that we are providing online instructor-led hands-on Azure trainings. If interested, please feel free to reach me on this WhatsApp number. Question 201. You have an on-premise data center and an Azure subscription. The data center contains 2 VPN devices. The subscription contains an Azure virtual network named VNet1. VNet1 contains a gateway subnet. You need to create a site-to-site VPN. The solution must ensure that if a single instance of Azure VPN gateway fails, or a single on-premise VPN device fails, the failure will not cause an interruption that is longer than 2 minutes. That means we are looking for active VPN connectivity from both the ends. Now the question is, what is the minimum number of public IP addresses, virtual network gateways, and local network gateways required in Azure? Let's understand this scenario by the diagram. So in simple words, we are going to obtain this scenario, where we are going to use our VPN devices on premises and we are going to use Azure VPN gateway on the Azure with 2 instances. Here we will see that if one VPN device fails, another will still be taking care of. So it will be active VPN connectivity from both the ends. Let's understand this scenario in more detail using learn.microsoft.com. We are on learn.microsoft.com and here we will understand how we can create a site-to-site VPN connectivity in the Azure portal. For that, we will be creating a virtual network which is provided, and then we will have to create a gateway subnet that is also provided in the question. Then we'll create a VPN gateway, and then we'll create a local network gateway in the Azure. Then we need to configure the VPN devices on premises, and then we can create the VPN connection. With the single VPN gateway instance, we will have this scenario. Both the end, we can see only single VPN gateway is there. Create VPN gateway. In this step, you will create a virtual network gateway, VPN gateway, for your virtual network. Here we will create a VPN gateway, and in VPN gateway we'll provide the public IP address. Here gateway type, we will select the VPN and we'll specify the values for public IP address. In public IP interface, if we are going to create a VPN gateway with active mode, we will have to supply the second public IP address as well. That means it will require 2 public IP address in Azure VPN gateway. When we enable active mode, as we can see here, second public IP address, select create new. This is available only if you selected enable active mode setting. Now next step is create a local network gateway in Azure. The local network gateway is a specific object deployed to Azure that represents your on-premise location for routing purposes. And you create local network gateway in Azure and you will select here IP address. Let's see how many local network gateway has to be created for 2 local VPN devices. We are on about active mode VPN gateways page in the learn.microsoft.com. Let's understand why create an active gateway. VPN gateway consists two instance of active standby configuration unless you specify active mode. Active standby mode behavior. In active standby mode, during any planned maintenance or unplanned disruption affecting the active instance, the following behavior occurs. The standby instance take over automatically and resume site-to-site VPN or VNet-to-VNet connection. And in this switchover cause the brief interruption. Under the active mode design, in active configuration for site-to-site connection, both instances of the gateway VM establish S2S VPN tunnel to your on-premises VPN device. So if you have one device, it's going to be like this. In dual redundancy active mode design, this is what we would like to achieve. We have two VPN gateway devices. Therefore, we will be creating on-premise VPN gateway 1 and on-premise VPN gateway 2. That means two local network gateway has to be created and one Azure VPN gateway has to be created. You create two local network gateways and two connections for your two on-premise VPN devices. Therefore, total public IP addresses required is equal to 4. 2 for Azure VPN, 2 for local network gateway. Virtual network gateways. Only one virtual network gateway with the two instances of VM is required to be configured. Local network gateways, since we are having two VPN devices or physical devices, therefore two local network gateways has to be configured in Azure. I hope this video was informative for you. Please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, press the bell notification icon. Thank you for watching this video. See you in next video.